Port Phillip Bay is where I got my hands dirty learning how to fish from a kayak. It's also where I've spent the past year teaching my son Fynn how to do the same. Surrounded by water to the east, west and south, there are plenty of fishing options here on the peninsula. I never have to travel far to get to the bays and I never have to paddle far to get to the fish. Flatties, whiting, squid and picky snapper can all be found close to land, making the bays rather convenient kayak fishing destinations. But I've been finding myself drawn to the ocean more often though, harassing Aussie salmon for kicks. They're not the tastiest fish on offer, but they are pretty exciting to catch. Hunting down schools of frenzied predatory fish with casting lures is more my style of fishing. Sambos, however, while fun to catch, don't really fulfill the nagging needs of my kayak fishing addiction. No, I have to jump in the car and drive over 2,000 kilometres north to scratch that itch. Myself and a posse of mates converge upon Fraser Island annually, gorging on a smorgasbord of kayak fishing nirvana for a week at a time. Here we find ourselves doing battle with a wide variety of species. Golden trevally are among our regular victims, most of the time hooking up on trolled Rapala CD Magnum lures. These fish fight like absolute troopers. Mac tuna always make an appearance and these fish are insane fun to catch, smashing both trawled and cast lures with gusto. We're not the only predators that like chasing them, but unlike the sharks swimming underneath our yaks, we're not that keen on eating them. Longtail tuna are far tastier and on average they're a lot bigger too. They put up a hell of a fight from start to finish and are one of our prime target species every trip. Catching a longtail is always a big deal. We hook our fair share of juvie black marlin on a variety of lures as well, and landing one is an even bigger deal. It's one thing to hook them, another thing entirely to catch them. They are incredibly good at spitting lures, and even with luck on your side, there's very little room for error. Marlin have been caught on our previous two trips, so this year we were hopeful to pull it off again. I've been daydreaming about it all year long. Carl Holger and I launched from the usual spot at Hervey Bay, this being our first expedition in May. With our kayaks packed with food, water and camping equipment for the week, we set sail for Wathumba Creek. And I was joined by Carl and Rhett on a second trip in November for more of the same, only this time we were hoping for a good run of marlin to come through as well. We were blessed with ideal launching conditions on both trips, making the crossing from Hervey Bay to Wathumba Creek a rather pleasant 55km journey. Launching early with the start of an outgoing tide gives us the best possible chance of arriving before sundown, which is critical. In November we pulled it off in under 6 hours, giving us plenty of time to play around along the way. As soon as we arrive at the creek, we drench ourselves in insect repellent, set up camp, pour a red from the cask, sit back and relax. And as we soak it all in, we're instantly reminded of why we keep coming back. It's not just about the fishing. The tides rushing in and out of the creek are stronger than they look, and sometimes making for hard work getting in and out. But when you clear the tidal current of the estuary and join the predators out in the bay, the piscatorial mayhem begins. But there are always casualties. Bitten off by mackerel, bust off by tuna, or spat out by marlin was frustratingly common this year, as always. Every day would begin the same. We'd start out with catching something tasty as a priority, as we relied upon fresh fish to complement our meals. Mackerel is a favourite amongst the group, so that's what we always target first. Some days they can be tricky to catch, easily spooked and fickle on lures. But we always find a way. It's all about matching the hatch and putting that lure where it needs to be at the precise moment, which is right into the thick of a surface-busting feeding frenzy. And we catch plenty of them trolling too. As soon as someone lands a fish that can feed us all, we inform each other by radio. From that point on, gaffs are banned and every other fish caught is returned to the water, back from whence they came. With dinner in the bag, we then turn our attention to more highly prized catches, which is pretty much anything with scales that swims hard enough to tow your kayak around. Birds are our fish finders. No need for a sounder here. Hooked this flighty fish back in May while trawling a Rapala CD Magnum. While they were tricky to catch, we also found our illustrious long-tail tuna. Will dropped several marlin on a variety of lures and live baits, but even though his camera failed to fully capture the moment, Rhett did manage to capture himself a little billy. And then it was my turn. This thing smashed my lure right while I was watching, just meters behind the boat, and it did it after having swallowed a live bait I was trawling on the other line. That's right, I hooked it twice, but because I wasn't aware of that, I cut the other line to prevent it from being foul hooked. This fish took me for quite a ride, going on a heavy run that threatened to spool me. I was able to gain line on the fish by sailing in the same direction as it was running and steadily reeling it in. When it got close, I furled the sail, grabbed my rod with both hands and held on tight. And that's when the fish went ballistic. The only thing separating me from this 60-pound fish right now is a short length of 20-pound Suffix Advanced Superline, a well-oiled Akumil reel, and my trusty Nitro Viper rod. I'm confident the combo's up to the task, but I'm not so sure about the Albright knot I used to tie on the leader, making me just a little bit nervous when this happens. Kilometers is a long way to travel to catch some fish, but when it comes to Fraser Island, it's always worth it. We'll be back.